now clearly the referee's instructions to the fighter.
And Floyd, this being a contest for the heavyweight championship of the world, will necessitate two major rule changes. The mandatory eight count will be waived. You'll resume boxing immediately after a knockdown. The other man will return to this neutral corner and remain there until I signal you to come out boxing. Now, is this understood? It's very important. Three knockdown rule will also be waived. There can be more than three knockdowns in any given round. I warn you now, you will be penalized for any unnecessary roughness or any infraction of the rules. Break when you're told to break. Good luck to both of you. Shake hands now. Return to your corners and await the starting bell.
Now to describe all of the action of tonight's fight, here is Les Tiger.
Thank you, Howard. Good evening again, sports fans across the land. Arthur Mercanti, the referee. Johansson is in white trunks. Patterson in black. Patterson in the corner to our right. Johansson to the left. They come out and they meet in the center of the ring. Speared by a left hand is Patterson. He backed away. Punch missed. Here's Patterson jabbing to the left. Starts into a crouch. Takes a light left jab on the forehead. Looking for that right hand. Johansson takes the left and then ties up Patterson. In close, a short right to the body. Neither man has really hurt. They're feeding each other out. Plenty of moss flying around in the ring between the fighters. All right, Patterson backing away, takes the light left jab on the glove. Johansson shoots the left jab out again. Patterson takes it on the gloves, backing away. Patterson comes in with a left and follow-up left that's taken on the gloves by Johansson. They tie each other up. Neither man has really been hit thus far. Mercanti moving around the fighters. Patterson goes into a slight crouch and stands up. He's more straight up than last time. Shoots the left that's taken on the right cheek by Johansson, backing away. Right to the left of the chin, almost dropped Johansson. And he comes back and hits Patterson, gets over the left by Patterson. Patterson hurt Johansson. Throws the right to the body. Johansson backs away, makes Patterson miss the left as he ducks under and ties him up. Johansson was hurt against the ropes. At least he was jolted. Now Patterson backs away and then moves in again. Goes into a crouch, stands up. We almost had a knockdown in the first minute. Johansson took one high on the cheek. Now he's tied up by Patterson. In close to the right, left to the body, in close. The crowd all excited, and now they've had an explosion. A light left to the head by Johansson twice as Patterson ducks. Patterson misses a straight left hook. Patterson comes in with a left to the body, a right to the chin, and plays up Johansson against the rope. And it's Patterson winning, taking a right to the side of the head by Johansson as he came off the rope. We had excitement in round one like we did not have last year. Johansson spurring with a light left. Patterson keeps going into the crowd, then standing up, and he's got Johansson buffaloed. Johansson, right left jab, misses as Patterson misses a left. Johansson backing away, top right. A left to the head thrown by Patterson makes Johansson duck. He looks awkward as he ties up Patterson, but he seems unmarked, even though he's been hit two or three times hard. A left to the mouth by Patterson, a left to the right by Patterson, and Johansson's knees buckled against the rope. Patterson up against the rope, throws another right to the air, and Johansson can't figure him out, misses a right. Gets Patterson back up against the rope, thus far. Although Johansson's been hit plenty, he doesn't look hurt, although there's a cut under the left eye. That's just developed. Here's Patterson missing a left jab. It's been all Patterson. Johansson sparing with a light left with Patterson backing away. Now Patterson in the crowd straightens up. Starts to move in on Johansson. A left jab thrown by Johansson is missed. Johansson has a definite cut out of the left eye. It's a slight one, however. No damage except for that. But Patterson's been throwing the heavy blows. Now Johansson pushes him against ropes right above our microphone. Throws a couple of light, harmless rights to the ear. Now at long range again. Johansson meeting a new Patterson tonight. This isn't the boy who fought him a year ago. Floyd, backing away now, seems more confident. He's hit Johansson more in one round than he hit him in three last year. Patterson going in at a crouch, ties up Johansson, hits him with a left hand close, makes Johansson almost smile. Takes a right to the body. Johansson makes a miss and hits him in the back of the head with a right. Johansson with his hardest punch with a right on the back of the neck. And now they're tied up in an awkward clinch as they break on voluntarily. Here is Johansson with a light left jab that misses twice. Patterson ducking. Johansson has thrown the right a couple of times. It's missed or landed high on the shoulder so far. It's been Patterson throwing bombs. Patterson with the left of the nose. That's the bell. That's the end of round one. Here is a word from Bufferin. Still a cut under Johansson's left eye. Johansson's fading red is less tighter. Look confident now. Patterson shoots a left hook and another one that misses. Round two just underway. Patterson keeps going into a slight crouch and then standing up, crouching. He's too hard left to the chin. The second one taken on the glove. Johansson has taken most of the leather right to the body by Patterson, right over our microphone. Patterson with a winging left from left field that was taken on the glove. It's made Johansson back away. Johansson backs away from the left, takes the left on the nose. Patterson throwing the dynamite, throws another left, and Johansson backs away. Patterson right to the body, taken on the kidneys by Johansson. Now at long range, Patterson misses the left. Johansson just pecking away, backing away. That left has a little more sting, that jab, than last year, but he hasn't thrown it much tonight. It's been Patterson, the offensive fighter so far. Here's Patterson to the left of Mrs. Jansen, a left and a right hand full. But Johansson, Patterson for the moment was in the old peekaboo, took it on the glove. Patterson misses a straight left. Johansson jabs to the left and misses. There at long range, Patterson throws a right to the body and a left to the head, but Johansson backpedaling away from him. Patterson, another straight left, but taken on the glove by Johansson on that massive chest. A right left to the head by Johansson. Another one taken on the glove. A right to the chin. Hurts Patterson. He almost went down. There was the right. Now Patterson is back to the left. Patterson breaking Johansson through that thunderbolt to hurt. Patterson is blinking, backing away in the whole corner. Johansson jabs at him once, twice. Right over on right. Patterson ducks him and hits him. Johansson the left of the body that buckled him for the moment. Patterson wakes up somebody in the corner. I don't know if he was doing that because he knew him or because he was jarred and hurt. Johansson now is Patterson back to his own corner. Johansson is proud, is pacing his. Now moving in. It's Johansson jabbing with the left, moving in after him, just like Joe Lewis used to stalk his man. Johansson stalking Patterson now. And Patterson's not coming out like he did in the first round. Takes away left to the head. Johansson stalking him. Back to the middle of the rope. Patterson apparently was badly hurt. He's standing up now, trying to bob and weave, get away, take the left, throws the right left, taking on the glove. Johansson with a light left. That takes the left and all, but Johansson was backing up this time, waiting for potential explosions either way now. Patterson back to the rope above it. Johansson, two right left jabs, another left and all, the right again. But Patterson was backing away, took most of the effect of that punch away. Here's Johansson with that right cock. Patterson into the crowd, just standing up, takes left head, throws the left of the body. Misses a wild right swing as Johansson gets hit on the eye with a right and a left of the body. And they're swinging away at close range. Patterson hits him with a right to the ear. Johansson with a right left jab. Either man could go down at any minute the way this fight's been going. Patterson misses a light left jab. This is one of the most insightful heavyweight fights in two rounds ever seen up to now. Here is Johansson backing away. Now at long range, Patterson crouching, standing up, takes three light left jabs thrown by Johansson. Johansson throwing away with it. Patterson misses the left, Johansson misses the right. As Patterson ducked under the right that time. Johansson takes the left as Patterson goes into his crouch, back into his own corner again. And Patterson goes after Johansson, who backs away from his left, takes the left to the nose, thrown by Patterson. And Johansson's left eye is cut underneath the eye now. 10 seconds left in round two, that eye is beginning to swell. Johansson's left eye underneath. Johansson missing three left jabs, Patterson backing away. Throws the left at the bell. And they speak momentarily. And now at the bell, here's Howard Cosa.
Okay, let's the second round. Another exciting round. We've had two great rounds now, and as Skyler and Liskite have told you, vastly different from the first fight. The first round, cleanly Patterson. The second round, close. One crushing right landed by Johansson on Patterson's nose, but at the same time, for the rest of them, Floyd has been ducking under them this time and using his left jab effectively. Patterson did wink right over our heads in this corner after that strong right by Johansson landed, and the man he winked at, strangely enough, was Jimmy Cagney. Patterson's getting used to movie actors in his corner. One of his memories from the last fight after the third knockdown was lying on his stomach and seeing John Wayne. But the way we see it thus far, Patterson the first cleanly, Johansson perhaps a shade the edge in the second because of the strong right that he did land that staggered Floyd. Endless fight.
Round three, both men look confident. Here's Patterson missing a light left. Johansson's left eye swelling. A light left jab taken on the glove. And it's Patterson to round one now as he jolts Johansson back. Moves in and then backs away, throws the left of the body. Tied up by Johansson this time. They're both work in close with light jolting punches to the ribs. Patterson's straight left hand, and he doesn't have that old square style. He has the left out, the classic stance. It's Patterson crouching, then standing up, then crouching, and he befuddles Johansson a bit. Throws the left to the head, and an elbow catches Johansson backing away. They're in close, tie each other up, and Marcondi, the referee, asks them to break, and they do. They smile at each other at the end of round two. Here's Patterson, light left jab, missing, ducking, taking the light left jab by Johansson, who backs toward his own corner. Johansson and White take the right to the body, protect his jaw as the left hand is taken on the glove. And now it's Johansson tying up Patterson, and Marcondi has to break him twice within 30 seconds. Patterson starts to go into the crowd, then straightens up, shoots a left jab, taken on the forehead. Johansson ducks under him, and like a wrestler, grabs a hold of his waist, and they tie each other up. Now right over our microphone, just together, clinching much more than they did in the first fight already. Johansson with that left hand moving left to right in front of him as he moves counterclockwise for a moment, then goes clockwise into Patterson's corner. Patterson shoots the left jab twice and follows it. We're waiting for the Patterson combinations. There's the left to the mouth. Patterson left to the body. Patterson the left taking on the elbow. Johansson the light left jab right over our mic as Patterson backs into the rope. Johansson trying to spear him with that light left jab. That eye closing again. Patterson's left. And a right hook is missed by Johansson, taken high on the head as Patterson ducked under him. Now it's Patterson with the left, taken on the glove by Johansson. The champion from Sweden, take a light left under the right eye that glazed him. And now it's Johansson with a light left jab, once, twice, and then Patterson into the crotch, shoots a straight left, taken on the glove. A light left to the head by the champion. And it's the ex-champion with a straight left to the nose that made Johansson blink. Johansson shifting from clockwise to counterclockwise. Two light left jabs, just pawing away, trying to set him up for you know what. Patterson with a light left jab. Patterson crouching, comes in with a left to the body and is tied up. And the mauls we mentioned are bothering the fighters. They're all over their body. They're all over their body.
Johansson playing one area under his left eye, a tiny cut in round one.
Clockwise again toward his own corner. Takes left the body and right to the head.
He's not effective. Patterson rocks the left into the elbow.
Johansson is smiling very frequently. It may be because he's been hit and hurt. It's hard to tell. There's Johansson's light left to the forehead. Twice and then misses the right as Patterson ducked under him. Patterson shifting beautifully defensively tonight. Beautiful footwork by Floyd Patterson, the boy from Rockville Center. Patterson ducks, then straightens up, then ducks again. Johansson with the left, taking a left in the nose, thrown by Floyd Patterson. And the ex-champion fires a straight left to the chest. Another left misses by Patterson. It's for Patterson around one again. Johansson misses a short right and a short left. As Patterson ducks, weaves, and bobs and weaves away, comes in with a light left to the body. Backing Johansson up, though the fans thought it was a bit low. Johansson hits the right left to the chest. And he tries up Patterson as he looks really quick. A right to left, a combination by Floyd Patterson. Patterson crouching, straightening up, bobbing and weaving. Johansson doesn't know how to figure him out for a moment. He has a bewildered look. Patterson figured that right hand out except for once in the second round. He ducked under it. Here's a left jab and a left to the eye thrown by Johansson, the best left jab he's thrown. Patterson missed the left, takes a light left to the air. Johansson, the champion from Göteborg, Sweden, backing away, then moving in. As Patterson bobs and weaves, mostly from a stand-up style. Patterson with a left, jolts once, faints once, and then throws it, taken on the chest by the champion. Patterson with a light left to the cheek. And another left to the mouth, taken by the champion. And a left misses. One thing, Johansson has shown he can take a punch up to now. No question about it. Here's left throw, but Patterson missing. Johansson moving clockwise again. Backs away from two wild lefts and then ties up Patterson. He tries to hit him with an uppercut up close, but Patterson is tied up. Johansson is warned, nods okay to Mercanti for a warning. And now there's Patterson into the crowd, shooting the left, missing. Johansson and they exchange left hands and tie each other up, and there's more clinching in this fight, and we've already gone longer than we did in the last one a year ago. It's round four, about a minute into the round. Patterson comes in with the left, tied up by Johansson. Johansson with the right hand poised, but hasn't been able to get a good shot at it except once in round two, and Patterson stood up to it, although he rocked. Two left jabs to the eye, thrown for the champion. Patterson misses a wild left, and Johansson, in his awkward defensive style, backing up, ties up the ex-champion. Now at long range in mid-ring. Patterson shoots the left jab, but miss comes in with a hard left to the body. The combination by the ex-champion again, and a punch is a little bit below the belt. Mercanti warns him to keep him up. Patterson hit below the belt. Johansson didn't seem disturbed. Here's Johansson blocking with a glove, throwing a right sort of half strength that time. He pawed with the right hand. Takes a left on the eye, backing away, almost rocking over to get away from Patterson's combinations, which are brought to the fore here tonight again. In close, now they're jabbing away, and then a hard right to the cheek. Anger Johansson as Patterson clips him in close. And Johansson moving counterclockwise now. Throws a hard right, backs away from a wild right that half pushed him into the rope. Johansson takes the left of the body and ties up Patterson. And the crowd sensing that the championship may come back to the USA the way Patterson's going. Johansson with that sneer now. As Patterson moves him with the left of the body and the left of the head in the combination, and Johansson ducks the second punch. 2 minutes into round number four. At long range, Patterson crutches, straightens up, misses a wild right cross. As Johansson, moving those fists constantly, shoots the left jab out. Johansson with the right in front of his chin, blocks a left hand, thrown by the ex-champion. Patterson, tied up now, and they're in close, just pawing away at each other. And that's when Patterson lashed out the last time. There's an uppercut that misses by Patterson. Johansson hits him twice in the air. They're right along the ropes above it. And Patterson puts a hard right to the air. He's doing well, in close, and angered by Johansson on the last exchange. All right, Ingemar backing away, takes left the body, and with those arms in front of him like claws, blocks the punches. Patterson misses the right, lands the left, takes the right to the head, thrown by the champion. Johansson with a light left, taken on the nose by Patterson, the left to the jaw, and a right in close by Johansson this time, but not doing any damage whatever. All right, Patterson backing away. Now Patterson into the crouch with his back to his own corner. 10 seconds left in the fourth round. Patterson throws two light lefts and then a hard left to the nose. Johansson ties him up and hit up behind the ear with the right hand. Hits Patterson with the right hand, and then ducks. And they tie each other up at the bell. They talk to each other at the end of the round, the end of round four.
Well, they've got the ice pack, just took it off under Ingo's left eye, round five coming up.
All right, a championship may hang in the balance here. Patterson has outclassed Johansson unofficially. Here's Patterson, two lefts and another long left, pushes Johansson into the rope. Ingemar comes off the ropes trying to figure out the Patterson style. A right thrown by Patterson on the cheek. And Johansson takes the left of the body, backing up. Patterson, the aggressor again. And he's hurting Johansson in close left to the nose by Patterson, tied up by Johansson. It's Johansson on defense, Patterson on offense. Patterson backed away from a right uppercut that missed, throws the left to the left ear, right ear of Johansson. This is a wild right hook as Johansson was backing away, and that had dynamite message on it. Patterson with the left to the eye as Johansson was backing away. Now the champion from Sweden, moves in with a light left jab. Takes the left of the body, backs into the rope. The left jab of Johansson not disturbing Patterson. One whiff. Oh, that's a jab of Johansson goes on his back. Johansson getting up to his knee. The champion on one knee taking the count of five. Six. He's on one knee. Since Evans senses the five. Six. He's on one knee. Since Evans senses the other Patterson. Nine. He's bleeding now on the right left. Johansson went down and the championship may be going now. Patterson moves him to the left and the right. The right to the chin. Patterson hits Johansson back to the rope. Patterson to the left and the right. Johansson fighting to stay up on his feet. Johansson trying to stay alive is hit twice in the back of the neck. Tries up Patterson against the ropes, but places bedlam. Hits twice. Patterson close to getting his crown back. A left to the chin. Turns Johansson around and hits him to the right. Johansson is the man who doesn't know where he is tonight. All right, Patterson moving in. Patterson dodges a wild right, takes a left to the body. Patterson with Johansson's right having no punch whatever. Johansson looks like a man sleepwalking. Patterson comes in with a left to the body. Johansson takes the right. Johansson a left to the body. Patterson up the chin and Johansson.
Connecticut, you'd know in the first round whether or not you'd knock him out. Did you know?
Well, Howie, I'm not going to kid. I did feel that I had a great chance of knocking him out after the first round. But he caught me with a very good right hand, and I tried to play coy. I tried to make like I was seriously hurt so he could follow up, but he never did.
Boyd, I know you were worried about Ingo. They're lifting him up now, and he does not seem seriously hurt.
You mind if I go over his...
I will let you go over, Floyd, in just a minute, if you'll give me just another minute, Floyd. When do you have a rematch coming up under the contract, Floyd?
In 90 days.
In 90 days.
Yes.
Do you feel that it will be much the same story then, that you've learned how to fight Ingemar?
Well, Howie, I can't say. I sure hope so.
You wouldn't boast about it?
No.
The ring mentality, Jack announcer, is talking to us about the photographers. One final question, Floyd. When you hit... Ingo, that first hard left hook that felled him. Did you know then that a knockout was sure?
No, I never take for granted of anything. I knew that my possibilities were greater than they were before I got in the ring when I caught him with the left hook.
Do you feel the extra weight helped you a great deal?
I'm punching much harder, yes.
And do you feel that your different style of training this time was much of the story, that you weren't stale?
Floyd from Great Britain. You've been on radio and television there. Congratulations to you from your Olympic viewers in Britain.
Thank you.
All right, Floyd Patterson moving away from us now, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to try to get to Ingemar Johansson. Now he's on his feet.
Five pounds in the greatest one that ever lived.
All right, let's go over to Ingemar. Eddie. Eddie, will it be possible, Eddie, to talk with Ingemar on microphone?
I don't know. Ask the doctor.
This is Edwin Alquist, ladies and gentlemen, the business advisor to Ingemar Johansson as Floyd goes over to see how Ingo is. Eddie, you knew it was going to be a very tough bout. Were you shocked by what happened?
I said it all the time. It would be a tough fight. Shocked? Anything can happen in boxing, as we say. So Ingemar gets clipped and he has a chance.
Well, you're a philosopher about it, Eddie. Do you feel that next time this will go for a change of style on Ingo's part, the way Floyd changed his tactics to this one?
I don't believe in changing his style.
You still feel that he can beat Patterson in a return match?
That's hard to say, but I think it'll be a tougher fight, yes. If you have beaten him once, he probably could beat him another time, but this was a hard knockout.
A hard knockout. How is the boy? Have you had any report on him yet? I don't want to go over and bother.
Oh, our Swedish doctor said it's, he'd be all right, he said. I asked him. He'll be our doctor.
Eddie, do you think we could talk to him for just a moment?
I don't think so, no.
As our viewers can see over our heads, but as our listeners can, Ingemar Johansson is not yet back in the corner of his ring. He is sitting surrounded by his Swedish and American trainers, Whitey Bimstein. We'll try and talk to Whitey Bimstein. Whitey, I hate to bother you now. We're told we've got a minute left here up in the ring. Whitey, is there anything you can say on Ingo's behalf at this moment?
No, I pulled away. Got hit with a punch, pulled away.
Well, do you feel the change of tactics will be called for in the return bout?
Well, one and one, then go again. I don't know. I got to stay here and watch this thing.
Okay. How does the boy seem to you, Whitey?
He's all right now.
Okay. We will not bother Ingemar Johansson, as you can see, and as we will tell our listeners, finally he has arisen to his feet. He's looking around, stunned, almost unbelieving at what happened to him. That's the story from ringside, or from the ring back to Les Kider at ringside.
All right, Howard, and pandemonium has begun to reign as the new champion, or once again champion, has left the ring. Johansson is still in the ring, and let us get the facts on the record. The kid who was born in New York, on the streets of New York, the first man to win back the heavyweight title. Now we pause briefly.
You're in tune with Color Radio in Billings, KBMY 1240 on your dial. Our time, 10 minutes past the hour of 8 o'clock, 53 degrees of temperature at the KBMY studios.
Johansson, the defeated champion from Gothenburg, Sweden, who ran into two of the most beautiful left hooks you've ever seen. The last one was the cleanest knockout that's seen in a heavyweight championship fight since the heyday of Joe Louis and Rocky Marciano. The left hook put Johansson flat on his back, and he literally bounced. And it took over 10 minutes before they could bring him around. Now he's in his corner, and many of his friends trying to get to him, many of his fans, and Ingemar will soon be leaving. But the story here tonight is Floyd Patterson, the boy who was knocked out in less than three rounds last time. And now, for those of you who may have been overexcited when it happened or who didn't hear it clearly, we're now going to play back a tape. But we invite you to stay tuned for that. We'll be coming up shortly. Right now, we pause briefly. And now, so you can hear the dramatic excitement again, here is the dramatic tape.
Guy, round five coming up.
All right, a championship may hang in the balance here. Patterson has outclassed Johansson unofficially. Here's Patterson, two lefts and another long left, pushes Johansson into the rope. Ingemar comes off the ropes trying to figure out the Patterson style. A right thrown by Patterson on the cheek. And Johansson takes the left of the body, backing up. Patterson, the aggressor again. And he's hurting Johansson in close to the left of the nose by Patterson, tied up by Johansson. It's Johansson on defense, Patterson on offense. Patterson backed away from a right uppercut that missed. Throws the left to the left ear, right ear of Johansson. This is a wild right hook. And Johansson was backing away, and that has dynamite message on it. Patterson with the left to the eye as Johansson was backing away. Now the champion from Sweden moves in with a light left jab. Takes the left of the body back into the rope. The left jab of Johansson not disturbing Patterson. One whiff. A left to the chin and Johansson goes on his back. Johansson getting up on his knee. The champion on one knee taking the count of five. Six. He's on one knee. He's having senses looking over Patterson. Nine. He's bleeding now on the right is a wild right, takes the left of the body. Patterson with Johansson's right, having no punch whatever. Johansson looks like a man sleepwalking. Patterson comes in with the left of the body. Johansson takes the right. Johansson the left of the body. Patterson up. It's Jim and Johansson. Caught on his back. It's all over, I believe. His eyes are closed. He's caught on his back to the left of 5, 6, 7. We have a brand new champion. 9, 10. It's all over. It's all over. Roy Patterson has knocked him unconscious.
Yes.
In just a moment or two, we're going to have the great privilege of talking to and letting you listen to the unbeaten former heavyweight champion of the world, Rocky Marciano, sitting here with us at ringside. Right now, we pause briefly. Originally Floyd Patterson, and sitting with us is a fellow who shared the excitement at ringside with many, many thousands of others, Rocky Marciano. More need not be said. Rocky, the first question I'm sure they want to hear come out of you is, what did you think of the left hook that Floyd hit him with that last time?
It was a beauty. He threw many, many good left hooks tonight, some to the body, most to the head. I thought he fought a perfect fight, and I'm glad I predicted that he would win the fight.
Rock, after the fourth round, were you beginning to wonder, or did you feel pretty confident from the Patterson standpoint?
I really, against the puncher, you're never sure. I thought Ingemar, if he could hit him squarely, solidly, could hurt him, and you know, the fight then takes on a different pattern. But Floyd sure had his wits about him tonight. He played he fought a perfect fight. Everybody here said his left hook was never better.
Rock, a year ago we said that Johansson, of course, is the man of the hour. 7 knockdowns, but let's not forget Patterson, who was so courageous in getting up. Tonight, it's the reverse. We've talked to Patterson, his left hook. He's a great champion and certainly the first ever to do what he's done. Let's not forget Johansson. Don't you think in the second round that Patterson was hurt with that one right hand that really landed on the mark?
Yes, he did get hurt. In fact, it hit him squarely, and it stunned him. He bowed his head, and it's a good thing that he stayed underneath the right-hand punches after that.
Rock, we want to thank you for talking to all of us tonight and wish you continued success in your out-of-the-ring endeavors, and we'll always remember one of the great champions of all time.
Thank you, Les, very much.
Mr. Rocky Marciano. And now we pause briefly.